Okay. So I don't have my gloves, but I have my wraps on today. And we're going to be doing just some kickboxing basics. We're going to start by warming up the body. Then we're going to remind ourselves what we did last time. So we'll do some jabs and some punching, a little bit of those knee kicks. And today we're also going to be exploring undercuts as well as the side hooks and hopefully a front kick or maybe a side kick as well. So with that, I encourage you just to take a moment to stand, to arrive, getting a nice sense of being grounded and connected. Tuning into your intention, you know, why you're here today. And we can bring the arms over the head as we inhale. Arms down as we exhale. Two more. Last one. And beginning to start walking or jogging in place. Starting to bring the hands up. Maybe even just shaking out the hands a little bit. And beginning to make some fists. So tightening the hands together. Remembering the thumb is on the outside, not on the inside. So thumb is on the outside, and we can just begin to kind of roll, starting to warm up the shoulders, the arms, breathing. Allowing the feet to stop running, hands on the side. And we'll begin some twist jumps. So the hands are one side. Then they're the other, and the feet are doing this, and we're twisting the upper body. Maybe bringing the shoulders and the elbows up even. Stopping that, bringing the feet wider apart, starting to make circles with the arms. And we're already being light on the feet, bringing those heels up as we circle forward. Circling the arms back. Work a little bit on asynchronization of the movement. One arm goes back, other arm goes forward as best we can. And going to the other side, one arm forward, other arm back. coming back to a nice little jog. To work a little bit on our movement, as when we box or kickbox, we're not always still, just moving to the left, to the right, turning the whole body left, back to the front, the whole body to the right. To the back, back to the left, back to the front, sliding to the left, sliding to the right, back to standing. Now that we're a bit warm, just stretching out the wrists, rolling them one way and the other, bringing the foot in, if you like, together, or just finding balance and working on the ankles, the feet. Making big circles now in one direction with the knee and the hips. And in the other direction, so inward now. Moving to the other side, shaking out that leg. And again, rotations with the wrists if you like. The foot can be all together, or just focusing on the feet. And then some wide rotations outward. And inward. Coming back to standing, shaking out the leg we just stood on. And then reaching it up, giving the knee a squeeze. Deep breath in and out. Working on our balance already. Bringing the foot back, stretching out the front of the leg, squeezing the butt cheeks, pushing out the hips. Foot down, repeating on the other side. Can go in, nice hug. Bringing it back, squeezing those glutes, pushing the hips forward, crown of the head towards the sky. Foot goes down, standing. Last little one that we'll do with the legs. Also supportive to hold on to something for this. We're just going to be swinging our foot forwards and backwards. Don't have to go high. And the same on the other side. Okay, I think we're warmed up. Stretched a bit, ready to come into our stance, getting ready to kickbox. Nice tight fist, thumb on the outside, elbows close in, protecting the organs, the rib cage, fists next to our cheeks, protecting the head. Nice tight, confined, core is engaged, light on the feet. And we'll jab forward. The foot that's forward, that's the hand that goes out. Aiming to hit as if we're aiming, looking at the mirror, trying to punch us ourselves in the face. Coming back each time to protect. Using the feet, twisting the hips to add more power. And just nice and slow for now. Maybe speeding it up. And back to standing, light on the feet. Switching the feet, so now the other foot is forward. Switch again. Switch. 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 So other foot is forward now, and we're jabbing with the other hand. Jab. Jab. Jab, front jab, breathing out on the jab, a little faster, and back, switching. So we'll jab now and punch. We jab with the front foot, arm goes back. And as soon as we start pulling the hand up, we punch with the other hand, the shoulder goes out. We're twisting on the feet, so we're using the foot, the hip, and as if we're punching from the ground. So jab, punch, jab, punch. Jab, punch. Remembering those elbows close to the chest, to the sides. Jab, punch. Just a few times on your own. Tight fists. Coming back. Maybe making more of a flow out of it. Jab, punch. Feeling free to bounce a little bit. As if we're actually maybe sparring someone. Come on. And switch sides. Other foot is forward. Jab, punch. Jab, punch. A few times on your own. Shaking it off, taking a few moments to catch your breath, grab something to drink if you need to. We're going to incorporate now what we did last time. So we're going to bring in our knees. This will be the last sort of remembering thing, and then we'll focus on the new movements. I'm showing you the side view. Let's say my right foot is forward. I'm here. And then we were doing the knee kicks. And we were exploring, you know, coming back, or we were kicking through. And then wherever for the time being is comfortable with the hands, whether bringing them down, but important to at least have one of the hands up so you could protect yourself. And stepping forward, coming back. So you can see I'm going up on the toes and I'm engaging the core and the glutes to push through. So a few of your on your own. I think I also introduced the one where you can imagine that you're actually grabbing someone. Bah. Grabbing your stress and kicking it through into next week. So we're light, we're protecting. Fists are up, we grab and hands go back up. You can also grab, come back, grab, come back. So a few more on your own, exploring how this is. And I know I'm showing the movements fast, but you can actually learn a lot with slowing down the movement. So doing what works best for you to learn. I know it might be difficult to still remember to have the fist tight, but you can also, right, depending sort of on your style of fighting, the hands can be open. Whatever works best for you. And we could switch to the other leg now. So let's say your left foot is now forward. We're repeating on the same, repeating in the same way. Exploring what works best for you. Really slowing it down. It can be a low knee. Maybe you want to go really high, really forward. Okay. Reminded ourselves about the knees. Now let's try to put it together. So we'll do jab, punch, knee, stepping forward. Okay. So we're in our position. One of the foots is forward. Fists protecting. We jab, we punch, we grab, and we knee. Stepping forward, hands come up. We could scoot back if we need to. And repeat on the other side. So we jab, punch, grab, knee, step forward, arms come up, protecting. Jab, punch, knee. Jab, punch, knee. Feeling free to add some breath or some yelling into it. Scare the neighbors. And a few on your own, trying to put it all together. Jab, punch, knee. Jab, punch, grab, knee. Ba, ba, ba. Ba, ba, ba. Ba. Or really slow. Ba, ba, ba. A few more. And already beginning to maybe imagine, you know, or visualizing some air sparring, what you would be doing, you know, moving around. As I was doing in the beginning, we could switch to face one way, jab, punch, kick. Then we go forward again, switch legs, switch sides, jab, punch, knee. So being playful. Okay, take a little bit of a break, just 30 seconds, grabbing something to drink. And yeah, maybe we'll do both. Yeah, we'll do both. So we'll do the hook as well as the undercut. and then we'll explore a front kick. So again, we're in the same stance like we started, light on the feet, fist tight, protecting. We know our jab and our punch. Now we're going to explore a hook with the arm that's forward. So the thing is that we don't want to give away what we're going to be doing until the last moment. So the opponent or the person that you're sparring with doesn't know exactly what you're going to do, so they can't defend it as well. So while we always kind of start the same, and in the last moment we kind of shift or change it up. So it's like as if you're getting ready to jab forward, but then we hook. So it's not like a hook like that, because you can see I'm winding up, big hook around, and there's a lot of counter movements or defense movements you can do in that. So it's not, wah. But if you'd like to start like that, you can. It's more forward, and then you at the end you jab through. So exploring that for a bit, the front arm. And when we come to the jab, what we're actually doing is we're moving sideways. So it's you hit them sideways in the jaw, temple, nose. So hooks. And the same on the other side. So we're coming forward and hooking. So it's not I wind back, big hook around. It's more of a kind of sneaky last moment, I hook. So exploring the hook with the other side. Nice tight fist. Remember those fingers on the outside. And maybe hook, hook. Left, right. Hook, hook. Hook, hook. Hook, hook. And we can switch sides, other foot forward. Now the hand that's more forward, that will be our front hook or right hook, depending which foot is forward. So practicing on your own, those hooks with one arm and the other, light on the feet, remembering to protect those organs. Blocking, we're kind of hunched forward. If you see me from the side. And after each punch, we quickly go back to protecting ourselves again. So back, back, back. Okay. Shaking out the arms. I'll actually skip the undercut today, but we'll do the front kick instead and then try to combine everything together and give you like two minutes to catch your breath before whatever's next. So the front kick, it's a lot like that knee, but we're actually then kicking out the foot. So we want to kick or hit with the ball of the foot here. So the toes are curled back. We're hitting with this soft part. There are variations where you could kick more with the heel, but just the standard is with that front. So just exploring a bit on your own. I recommend just to go low in the beginning. So one knee goes up if we're trying to kick something in front of us. So we don't want to kick with the toes, because we could break them kicking forward. We're kicking with that ball of the foot, kicking out in front of us. You can see I'm coming back, but a more powerful kick is stepping really into it, using our whole body to also push into them. But just taking the time, maybe going slower. And if you already have kicks in your practice, then you can explore, you know, maybe the medium, maybe the high kick, three kicks. Just taking some time to explore. And remembering that breath, that noise. So often in different martial arts, you'll hear them say something like in famous karate, kia, kia. The yelling helps you just to release the energy and the force. Okay, so front kicks we have. Now let's put it all together and we'll do starting position, jab, punch, knee, switch sides,